We're focused on a project, we're focused on the aim, we're focused on the plan. We're not blinkered to the point that we're going to take too many risks that will jeopardize not only our lives, but the whole project. What I'd like to do is take you through some of the words that were mentioned today, a journey, a very personal journey of mine, very pictorial, and just tell you a story, basically, and the best way to do it is through the pictures. But in the back of your mind, remember, it's not just about maintaining this high-performance team. It's obviously, you'll see as we go through this, identifying the potential and then creating it. And everybody's responsible for creating that high-performance team. There were a lot of challenges we went through right from the beginning to get the finance, to develop the team, to get volunteers, to actually execute the plan as such. I honestly believe our biggest success was getting to the start point. The rest of it then was down to us. And what you're about to see really is not about what we were trying to achieve, it's more about how we did it. It's not just the what, it's the how. And it's the how that actually comes from the people themselves. Now, I didn't just wake up one morning and decide that I want to get a group of like-minded people and set off next week and walk to North Pole. It was a whole education program. And it was learning from past mistakes, learning from previous trips of my own and other teams I've been involved in. But also research. I went back 25 years of modern polar history, and I read every book, used the internet, used the libraries, the Royal Geographic Society. I went around Europe interviewing people that had attempted it to try and find out why they didn't make it. I wouldn't say why they failed, because there's only one in 150,000 people attempt this. So to get to the start point is an achievement, but they didn't make it all the way, so they didn't complete their project as such. And I found out, as I went through the research, that people were trying to achieve too much, whether that's individuals within the team or the project itself. And we were a victim of this when we skied across Iceland. We tried to put too much into the agenda and trying to achieve too much. That actually diluted the focus. So what you're about to see or hear is a very, very selfish story. We had one common goal, one aim. In the back of your mind, everything the team did, every thought, every question, every action, every reaction, always had to bounce back to what is in the best interest of delivering this project. We're, like any project, we're up against time constraints, so we didn't have the beauty of a lot of time on our hands. Even though we spent a lot of time researching it, actually once we went live and we told the world we were going to do this, we only had 6 months to get the team together, to train the team, develop the team, and actually get the project on its feet to the start point. Now, my research, my own personal research, was 4.5 years on my own, in between the day job. Every winter, I went over and lived with a family of Inuit Eskimos to understand how their culture worked. How did they live and survive at minus 50, minus 60? How did they hunt, so on and so forth? I also did all my own trials, equipment, clothing, and all the things we would need for the trip, for two reasons. One, to test myself, and have I got those capabilities to actually lead the high-performance team? But more importantly, thinking about the team, I wanted to make sure once we went on the ice and they were live and that the project was going ahead, they weren't worrying about the equipment they've got, they're worrying about their own performance. So if people's walking along worrying, have we picked the right sledge, have we got the right sleeping bag, they're stopping thinking about themselves and driving themselves forward and pushing their own boundaries. So there was 4.5 years worth of research. Not really sought anyone's intelligence, there were 4 North Poles out there, 4 South Poles. We wanted to go to the main North Pole, the geographical North Pole, the top of the world. And this is all relevant to part of the challenge. We have to go to the top of the world when obviously the ocean was frozen. So we have to start off in complete darkness at minus 55 degrees Celsius. Now, if that wasn't hard enough, we wanted to go the wrong way, the hardest way possible, which is from the Canadian coastline. And the reason why it's so difficult is that the Arctic Ocean, it drifts from Siberia to the North Pole and carries on towards Canada. So in effect, we're walking against the tide. So we would walk forward, for example, all day, we'd make a mile. During the time in the tent at night, we'd drift back too. So we would wake up a mile behind where we finished the day before. So imagine the problem and challenge I had recruiting a team to come on this journey. Once you look at it on paper, you just think there's no way you can deliver this.